This is my 1.6 petrol version TU5JP4 Peugeot 307 2007, roughly about 55,000 miles. And what I have a problem is that the alternator is probably already gone and doesn't produce enough volts. Well, sometimes it produces volts, sometimes it doesn't. It's a bit intermittent. So what I've decided to replace my alternator. So this video is how to replace the alternator in your Peugeot 307 2007 or the 1.6 petrol version model. So the alternator is down here on the left of the engine, but the problem is it has two bolts on the left side, two bolts on the right side, and this particular shield, this aluminium shield, is really in the way. It's held by four bolts, one, two, three, and four bolts, but they're really rusty because most of the times they are just under extreme heat. The engine is too hot, then it cools down and they're really rusty. So I don't want to snap these off, then it's a whole lot of problem. I have to make a thread and so on. So I'll be using PV Blaster that I've used a couple of times to loosen rusty bolts. So basically, as you can see in this video, I spray on the bolts each individually with this PV Blaster. I have been doing this for the last 2 days or so to spray on those. Now it's a day or so past after I've sprayed, and then with a hammer slightly knock on the bolts, not really at all heavy at all, just slightly knock them, so it kind of sends shock waves to these bolts to kind of loosen the rust and to help this whatever the liquid is in this PV Blaster to go inside in the threads to loosen a bit the rust. So hopefully these will now be fairly easy to undo. So the next thing to do the alternator, I want to remove that because you can't put a wrench in here and undo the bolts. So next thing is to remove that aluminium shield. So these bolts are 10 millimeter, but it's a bit on the loose side, the 10 millimeter. So what I found is 3/8 socket, and it really fits quite snug on this bolt, so it's easy not to. I don't want to, because there is quite a bit of rust on these, I don't want to round them, so that's why I'm using 3/8, and it's pretty good. So let's see if the soaking with the PV Blaster will work. So next thing is to lift the shield, and it's simply, this is cut in between, so you can just slip it underneath and it should be quite all right. Let's see. Yeah, this actually works quite all right there. Let's see if I can lift it out here. You need just to push the radiator a bit, otherwise this doesn't come out very easy. Of course, now there is access to the alternator, the bolts down there, hopefully there is access. And this is what I've bought. It's a Bosch alternator, same as my current one. This is 14 volts, 120 amps. I don't think there is any difference between the 12 volts and the 14 volts. They all produce roughly about 14.3 to 14 point volts to charge the battery. So whether you order a 12 volts or 14 volts is the same thing. This is 120 amps alternator. It has this nut here for the positive that the electricity comes off. And what I was saying, these are the two bolts here and here. So the problem is that I cannot put a wrench in here because it has to come here and then undo it, and then a wrench in here and undo it, and there are two bolts from that side as well. It's a 6 rips belt there, and but that's it. That's Bosch. All the description is down below in the video. All the numbers for my alternator, yours might be different, so you have to check if the alternator that you're gonna order is the same as the one that you're replacing. So these are two bolts that you have to undo. Next is to undo that bolt on the actual alternator and remove the metal, the kind of wire that goes to the battery. Of course, before doing that, you have to undo the belt, the 6-rip belt. There is a pulley down here that you push down. It will lift, and then you remove the belt. And that's it. Not too sure what can be seen. I tried to do it with kind of left hand and then remove it with the right hand. You probably can't quite see, but that's the wrench on the pulley there. Push it down and then with one hand undo the belt on the side. Then you have to push quite hard actually. Then of course undo the belt. And my watch is in the way. That's why you shouldn't have a watch while you're working on car. So I've undone the belt. I can remove that. Forgot to say that this is 15 millimeter socket to do the pulley here at the bolt. Next is to undo that bolt, and this is where the electricity comes from, the positive. Otherwise it's connected to the engine, so that's how the negative goes to. So the positive, and this is 13 millimeter socket to undo. This worked all right, and it's quite tight. Of course, before working on the car, undo the positive or the negative, undo the positive battery clamp. Do not do that unless you've turned off the battery or removed the positive clamp. I've already removed that, so that's why I'm working on it. And there you go, you can remove the positive lid down here. There is also the plug here, and it's basically you put something here as a in terms of a screwdriver and just lift it like that. I'll show it later on. I'll try to undo it now. So I have a small screwdriver to kind of help me undo the plug, and I can't quite see. There we go. So basically for the plug, I'm pushing on that little pin here with the screwdriver and unplug the plug. And that's almost everything. Next is to undo the bolts that hold the alternator, one here and one underneath. I'll show the other one and two on the other side. So I'll first start with this just to see, because it's easier to get to that one and see how much effort I need to do. These are 16 millimeter socket. Not too difficult at all actually. It's pretty easy to get these bolts. The one bolt underneath, so this is the pulley, the bolt is down here. I don't need to remove the pulley because it's not in the way. For some models it might be in the way, in mine it's not in the way, so I can undo that bolt. I mean, it's the same thing really. That bolt is moving, and that bolt underneath. So next, the two bolts on the right side, which are a lot tougher to get to. So that bolt is down here. You cannot really see it, but it is how I have to push the radiator so I don't damage it. The upper is done. It doesn't move because there is one bolt underneath. It's down there. It moves slightly. All four bolts are undone, and that should be able to start it to shift slightly the alternator. I'll probably undo the first two bolts on the bottom and then in the top. That's the bottom bolt. Well, it's pretty big and hefty bolt, the bottom left. Next I'll undo that bolt on this side, kind of a bit more. One has to be a bit of a contortionist for these bolts. And I think when I undo that one, this straight away comes out. You don't need to undo, only slightly you need to undo that bolt because it slides in. Let me undo that bolt. Yeah, there we go, it's sliding out. There we go, I've done that bolt. The upper right. And then it should be able to actually slide it out like that and pull it out. Yeah, there we go. It came out. So this is what I'm talking about. This bolt has a, when this tightens, it has a, it's kind of, it's conical. Let me undo it all together. That's the upper right bolt. So it's kind of conical, the bolt. So when it pushes, this extends and it makes a, it makes it tight and it doesn't move at all. So you don't need to remove that bolt. Same with that one. You don't need to, you just need to undo it only slightly, and that's kind of easy. So that's the old alternator. I mean, that's how it looks like. These are the numbers, and it's a Mitsubishi alternator, 120 amps. All the components are in the description of the video, so you want to check all these components. Now is the moment to compare the two alternators. Definitely the diameter here is the same, and it's exactly the same. I am nearly certain they're exactly the same alternators, but just in case, this, they are six. This diameter is the same. And also check the two plugs have exactly the same plug and so on, and compare them to see that they're the same. Next thing is to swap the new alternator in. Hopefully I can do it fairly easy. Basically it should slot, the two bolts can both go inside. There we go. I mean, that top bolt is inside and the bottom is also inside, doesn't move. Now I can put the upper bolt properly, and then I can put the bottom bolt now. So I've pre-tightened that bolt and the one underneath. So I'll pre-tighten those on the right and at the bottom. And then that. Then, of course, torquing them up. And next is to torque all four bolts. And that's 40 newton meters plus minus 1 newton meter. So 40 newton meters. I'll do that first. So that one upper bolt, I tried all possible things to fit this torque wrench anywhere. I just couldn't fit it anywhere, so I'll tighten it by hand. Well, 40 newton meters, if you can fit something. Not too sure, it could be done from probably underneath the car, but my air conditioning unit there, it's in the way. I don't want to remove that because all the bolts are rusty. I don't take that one out. So it's, yeah, basically by hand. Should be about 40, I think. I'll see if I can torque the bottom one, the upper one. These two on that side I torqued, but this one I cannot torque. I'll see what I can do from the bottom one. Also, I cannot put any wrench on the bottom one, so it has to be again by hand. If I can see, it's pretty dark in there despite all the light. So again, it has to be by hand. So all tighten, doesn't move. Well, of course it won't move. These two are 40 newton meters each. On the right side, I did it quite hard, not too bad. Might check them in 100 miles or so, just to see if they're moving. Next, of course, is to put the positive in here. Click in the probe as well. And the positive, I've got a new nut from Bosch, which is actually quite good. Doesn't so much matter if it's old or new. So next thing is to put the belt on. You push on the pulley that way down and then fit the belt and make sure that the belt fits perfectly around. I mean, you could remove the cowling on around the tire and from that side, but I'm too lazy. I'll do it the hard way, like trying to do it with left and right hand and so on. But it shouldn't be too difficult. First, trying to put it on the underneath pulley, and I try to see if everything fits all right on the other ones. They seem all right. Push on that one and fit the belt. You can't see anything, of course. Let's see now. I mean, it seems to that I've positioned it quite well everywhere. I mean, down there as well, down here as well, seems quite all right. Not that many other checks you can do, but that's done at the moment. Next is to fit the shield here, and you simply slot it in. I'll try to push the radiator inwards so I don't damage it that much. Well, maybe I've slightly here damaged, but well, I haven't damaged it at all. It's just slightly, the fins are slightly inwards, but that's fine. Next is to put the bolts, and these are pretty rusty bolts. I mean, I might eventually zinc coat these bolts, and you can see the video here how I do that. But currently, because I just want to see if this alternator will work, I'll put ceramic grease on that. It's a plus 1,500 degrees centigrade, so it should be quite all right to hold on for the moment. Only very slightly on the tread. Next thing, of course, is to connect the battery, because I've disconnected in order to change the alternator, and then start the car and measure if it's delivering enough volts to the battery. And I have my multimeter, and I'll put it to 20 volts. Let's put it like that. Positive, negative. And it's 14.22 volts, so in other words, the alternator is working perfectly. And this is it. Thank you very much indeed for watching. This is how you replace the alternator in a 1.6 petrol version Peugeot 307. Maybe I made a bit of a mistake with this grease on the bolts there, because it was smoking a bit and burnt off. Supposed to be 1,500 degrees centigrade. But this is it. It works perfectly. No noises or anything. It delivers 14.3 volts. So it works perfectly. Thank you very much indeed for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Thank you.